have got dreams, and on this vacation, I am trying to fulfill most of my dreams. And this has always been on my list to explore the famous temples of Angkor Wat in Cambodia. And that's why I'm here in Siem Reap for. I'm also being joined by a couple of locals over here who are going to guide me on this trip, and we are going to drive some fancy cars. So I'm really excited for the trip. So let's begin the adventure of Cambodia. We are starting the day with a breakfast, and people over here like eat very heavy breakfast. Like they eat rice with pork because obviously it's the first meal of the day, so they want to keep it like heavy. And this thing is very new to me. I've never tried this before. It's called chak wai. And I don't know what it is made of, but it tastes a little bit like croissant. The main entrance for the temple, temple of Angkor Wat, and you can see right in behind me, like right there, and we're gonna go now and explore the temples. A little bit of information, these temples were built in early 12th centuries by the Khmer king Suryavansham, dedicated to Lord Vishnu, and then slowly it got transformed into a Buddhist temple, and right now it's one of the most popular attraction over here in Cambodia. This temple has gone through a lot of destruction through the war, because of the flora and fauna growing around. And there are a lot of external factors, but the government over here has been taking really good care of these temples, and that's what is keeping them still strong. And it's also there present in the flag of Cambodia, and these temples still look so beautiful. So now we have reached the second location for the day. It's Bayon Temple. The temple looks really, really beautiful. And just in case if you're wondering why no drone shots, so it's a little complicated over here. Like I try my best everywhere where I can, but over here the government is a little more serious about drones. Like if you fly a drone and if you are caught, they literally put you in jail, and I don't want to go to jail. So yeah, like let's go and explore this beautiful temple. It's called Bayon Temple. When you meet somebody, like how do you greet them? Like you just straight away go and say chumrip su.
Chumrip su, ta nek sok sabai chit te.
Chumrip su,
ta nek sok sabai chit te. Like hello and how are you?
Okay.
Yes.
Chumrip su, ta nek sok sabai de.
Chit te.
Oh, nice.
Yes.
Am I pronouncing that correct?
Yeah.
Okay.
Very nice.
Interesting language.
Yes.
So this temple is like really beautiful from inside, and you can't get enough of this temple. Like you can keep walking around, you can keep filming, and it'll just not be enough at all. And now we are heading to our next location, which is Temrom Temple, which is almost half an hour away from here. So yeah, that's the scene for now. And this place, like, look at this place, man. This is so beautiful. It looks so ancient, and although it's very sunny, it's hot. It's very, like, I'm literally sweating like anything, but yeah, I mean, this place, look at this place. So now we have reached the third location for the day. It's Taproom Temple, and this is the same place where Tomb Raider was shot. Now I'm not 100% sure, but then that's what the guy told me, like, who was driving. The Tomb Raider was shot here, so I'm really excited to go inside, and let me just show you around. So this is it. This is the place from where a lot of sequence from the film Tomb Raider was shot. Although this place is under construction right now, but then I can just imagine, man, like, this place would have been so nice when it would have been, like, totally in shape. Looks beautiful. So done with the lunch, done with the temple, and now we are going to the next location, Kampong Phluk. We had plans of going to our hotel, but I think it's getting cloudy and it's getting very late. And that is one place which is actually the floating village. And there we can actually fly the drone. And I don't want to miss the sunset flying my drone over there. So now we are heading to Kampong Phluk. And it started raining. It's raining right now. Just made it on time before the sunset, and look at the views, man. This place is so beautiful. Now we'll just quickly go on the boat and we'll start the boat ride, and meanwhile I can show you around. We have finally made it to the village. This is the village Kampong Phluk. This is the floating village, and the life over here is, like, totally different. You can see, like, people have their houses floating, like, literally it's on the water. They communicate or they do the transportation through the boats, and there are some lightning happening right behind me, and it started raining. So probably, like, we'll wait for some time, and I mean, if the rain stops, I can show you this beautiful village. And it really feels really nice to be here. I mean, I don't know, like, if I would ever get to see a floating village for real. Like, this is a floating village. We'll be right back.
Thank you.